सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फाइव मोर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज विच आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, और इसमें आपको सारे नोटिफिकेशन मिलते रहेंगे। सब्सक्राइब कर लो, बेल पे प्रेस कर दो। ओके, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन। सो द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, consider the following statements regarding socio-economic profiling of PM Swanidhi beneficiaries and you have to identify the correct statement. So the government is doing socio-economic profiling of the beneficiaries of PM Swanidhi scheme. So guys, I hope you all must know about the PM Swanidhi scheme that was recently launched by the government of India, under which street vendors are provided with a loan of rupees 10,000. Okay. उसमें 10,000 रुपए का लोन दिया जाता है by the government of India, and recently सोशियो इकोनॉमिक प्रोफाइलिंग की जाएगी ऑफ द बेनिफिशियरीज ऑफ पीएम स्वनिधि। नाउ व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस सोशियो इकोनॉमिक प्रोफाइलिंग? सो अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम, अंडर दिस सोशियो इकोनॉमिक प्रोफाइलिंग, अ कंप्लीट प्रोफाइल ऑफ ईच पीएम स्वनिधि बेनिफिशियरी एंड देयर फैमिली विल बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, एंड थ्रू दिस प्रोफाइल्ड डेटा ऑल द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट स्कीम वेयर these beneficiaries are eligible to get the benefits, the benefits of all these schemes will be provided to them using this profiled data. All right, and the number of cities where this social profiling will be done is how much? 125 cities mein social economic profiling ki jayegi. And who is the implementing partner? It's Quality Council of India. That is very important to remember. The implementing partner, you can say this socio-economic profiling will be done by Quality Council of India. Okay, and it has been launched as a pilot project in 6 cities, which are Gaya, Indore, Kachin, Nizamabad, Rajkot, and Varanasi. And this Kachin, guys, is located in Manipur. And I hope rest of the cities you must know ye kahan pe located hai. All right. So that's it about the socio economic profiling. I hope this news is clear. So socio economic profiling of PM Swanidhi beneficiaries has been done to provide those beneficiaries further benefits of the other central government schemes where they are eligible to get the benefits. All right. और 125 सिटीज में ये सोशियो इकोनॉमिक प्रोफाइलिंग की जाएगी। क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया इज द इंप्लीमेंटिंग पार्टनर, और 6 सिटीज में इसको एज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट लॉन्च किया गया है। ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस क्वेश्चन। यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स। थ्रू दिस प्रोग्राम गवर्नमेंट स्ट्राइव्स टू गिव सोशियो इकोनॉमिक बेनिफिट्स टू द बेनिफिशियरीज ऑफ पीएम स्वनिधि। यस, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट। दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च फॉर 125 सिटीज। यस गाइस, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट। And the implementing partner is, of course, Quality Council of India, which is the third statement, which means the third statement is also correct. So therefore, guys, option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 2. Dr. Carolina Arajo has won the Ramanujan Prize for Young Mathematician 2020. And guys, remember, she is the first non-Indian to win this prize. Okay, she is the first non-Indian. She is from Brazil. All right, she is from Brazil. So she has won this award, Ramanujan Prize for Young Mathematician 2020. The question is, which of the following organizations funds this prize? इनमें से कौन सी organization है जो इस prize को fund करती है? Okay. So let's talk about this news, guys. So as I told you, Dr. Carolina Araujo has won this award, Ramanujan Prize for Young Mathematician 2020. And guys, this award has been given by the Institute of Pure and Applied Mathematics, which is located in Rio, in Brazil. Okay. And why this award has been given to her? For her outstanding work in the field of algebraic geometry, उनके जो algebraic geometry के field में उन्होंने work किया है, उसके लिए this prize has been given to her. And talking more about this news, so guys, this prize awarded annually to a researcher from a developing country only. Remember this, जो researcher है वो कहाँ का होना चाहिए? Developing country का. The researcher should be from the developing country. That is funded by the Department of Science and Technology in collaboration with International Center of Theoretical Physics and the International Mathematical Union. So guys, remember this award is funded by Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. And remember, Department of Science and Technology is completing 50 years in the year 2021. 2021 mein iske 50 saal pure ho jayenge. And she is the first non-Indian to receive this prize, and the prize carries $15,000 cash award. Isme cash award milta hai $15,000 ka. And this is funded by Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. Okay, and remember, who gives this award? The Institute of Pure and Applied Mathematics, which is located in Rio. Okay, So therefore, the correct answer should be we have to find the organization which funds this prize. So this organization is option A, Department of Science and Technology, which works under the Ministry of Science and Technology. And now let's move on to question number 3. Before moving, let me tell you, when is the National Mathematics Day? National Mathematics Day is observed every year on 22nd of December. That is the birthday of S. Ramanujan. And also remember the International Mathematics Day. Don't confuse between the National Mathematics Day and International Mathematics Day. International Mathematics Day, guys, is on 14th of March. Alright. So this is international and this is national. This is because of the birthday of S. Ramanujan. And now let's move on to question number 3. You have to consider some statements regarding this award. United Nation Population Award. Okay. United Nation Population Award diye gaye hain abhi. And you have to find the incorrect statements here. So let's talk about this award, United Nation Population Award. So guys, there is an charity in our country which is known as HelpAge India. HelpAge India works for the reproductive issues, reproductive health issues. So this institution, HelpAge India, has been presented this award, United Nation Population Award, in the institutional category. Okay. While in the individual category, Bhutan's Queen Mother Gyalyo Sanghe Wangchuk has been awarded this prize in the individual category for her work in the on the sexual health and ending gender violence. Okay, so you have to remember the objective also. In the individual category, she has won this prize, while in the institutional category, India's HelpAge India has won this prize. Okay, and now talking more about this award, United Nation Population Award. So every year, guys, every year there is a committee for the United Nation Population Award, which honors an individual and or an institution. Individual को भी मिल सकता है, institution को भी मिल सकता है, या फिर दोनों को मिल सकता है, जैसा कि इस बार हुआ है. ठीक है, both individual and institution also can get the prize in recognition of the outstanding contribution to the population and reproductive health issues. Population or reproductive health issues से related अगर कोई institution या कोई individual work करता है, कोई अच्छा काम करता है, तो उसको अवार्ड दिया जाता है यूनाइटेड नेशन पॉपुलेशन अवार्ड द्वारा. एंड एवरी ईयर दिस अवार्ड हैज बीन डिसाइडेड बाय द कमिटी ऑफ यूनाइटेड नेशन पॉपुलेशन अवार्ड. ऑलराइट. एंड इट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड गाइस इन द ईयर 1981 बाय यूनाइटेड नेशन जनरल असेंबली. एंड फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम इट वॉज गिवन इन द ईयर 1983. ओके, 1981 में इसको एस्टैब्लिश किया गया था एंड पहली बार इसको दिया गया था 1983 में. एंड इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ गोल्ड मेडल, diploma and a monetary prize. And remember, the United Nation Population Fund serves as the secretariat of United Nation Population Award. Yani United Nation Population Award aisa nahi hai ki koi alag se koi organization deti hai. So United Nation Population Fund hai, wahi uska secretariat ki tarah serve karta hai, which means this organization gives this award. All right. So that's it about this award. And now let's come back to the question. You have to find the incorrect statement here. HelpAge India has been presented the 2020 awards in the institutional category. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is a charity that is working in India. The award was established in the year 1980. So guys, is that 1980? No. Is that? It is 1981. And the very first time when it was given was the year 1983. And United Nations headquarters serves as the secretariat of United Population Award? No. It's the United Nations Population Fund's secretariat which is working as the secretariat of United Nations Population Award, which means this statement is also incorrect. So we have two statements incorrect here, which means option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. So you have to consider the following statement regarding Climate Ambition Summit 2020. So this summit, guys, was held to mark the anniversary of Paris Agreement. You all must have heard of this agreement that was signed in the year 2015. So to mark its anniversary, this summit was held, and you have to identify the correct statements. Okay, so let's talk about this summit. So guys, as I told you, it was held to mark the 5th anniversary of Paris Agreement at Glasgow in Scotland. कहाँ पे हुआ था ये आपको याद रखना बहुत जरूरी है, ग्लासगो स्कॉटलैंड में. एंड व्हाट वाज द ऑब्जेक्टिव? टू सेट आउट न्यू एंड एम्बिशियस कमिटमेंट्स अंडर द थ्री पिलर्स ऑफ द पेरिस एग्रीमेंट्स. एंड व्हाट आर दीज थ्री पिलर्स? यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज थ्री पिलर्स. दीज आर मिटिगेशन, अडेप्टेशन एंड फाइनेंस कमिटमेंट्स. जो भी देशों ने पेरिस एग्रीमेंट को साइन किया है, उनको तीनों पिलर्स पे काम करना पड़ेगा, उनके जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है उसको अचीव करना पड़ेगा, जो भी टारगेट्स है उनको अचीव करना पड़ेगा. राइट. एंड रिमेंबर दिस समिट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय द यूनाइटेड नेशन, यूनाइटेड किंगडम एंड फ्रांस अलॉन्ग विद चिले एंड इटली. ओके, चिले एंड इटली, इन तीन देशों ने, यूनाइटेड नेशन, यूनाइटेड किंगडम और फ्रांस ने मिलकर इसको ऑर्गेनाइज किया था. साथ में ये दो कंट्रीज जो थी वो एज अ पार्टनर की तरह वर्क किया. ओके, एंड इंडियाज अचीवमेंट्स एंड टारगेट्स. सो दीज गाइज अचीवमेंट्स एंड टारगेट्स हैव बीन cited by Prime Minister of India during his speech at the summit. So these are the targets or these are the achievements that have been cited by our Prime Minister. So India has reduced her emissions intensity by 21% over the 2005 level. So 2005 mein hamara emission level tha, wahan se hum 21% kam ho chuke hain. Then we have our solar capacity has grown from 2.63 gigawatts in 2014 to 36 gigawatts in 2022, and we have to achieve this. We have to achieve 100 gigawatts by the year 2022. Our renewable energy capacity is the fourth largest in the world. हमारी जो renewable energy की production की capacity है वो पूरे दुनिया में चौथे number पे है. Then and this will reach 175 gigawatts before 2020 as the target set by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy under the Government of India. And we have an even more ambitious target of achieving 450 gigawatt of production of renewable energy by the year 2030. So these are some targets and achievement that were cited by the Prime Minister during his speech at the summit. So you have to remember these targets, guys. And now let's move on to the question. So we have to find the correct statements. It was held at United Nations headquarters, New York. No, it was held at Glasgow. And Glasgow, we all know, is in Scotland. It marked the anniversary of Paris Agreement. Yes, this is absolutely correct. The fifth anniversary of Paris Agreement. And it was organized by United Nations, UK and France. Yes, so these are the three, two countries and one organization which organized this summit. Okay, so two and three statements are absolutely correct, which means option A, only two and three will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number five, which is the last question for today. This question, guys, can be asked in your one marker ESI's, jo one marker ke questions hote hain, wo usme ye pucha ja sakta hai, because it is directly related to the Skill India mission. Okay, so the question is, with which of the following edutech company NSDC, which is National Skill Development Corporation, has signed an MOU for supporting the skilling of teachers and trainers under the Skill India mission. So guys, I hope you all must know about the Skill India mission. Skill India mission mein Bharat Sarkar skill provide kara rahi hai, and thereby they are providing employment opportunities to the youth of our country. Aur uske liye National Skill Development Corporation has signed this MOU with an edutech company which is known as Byju's. Okay, so Byju's ke saath ye MOU hua hai. Option B, Byju's, here is the correct answer. CEO of Byju's is Mr. Ravindran Byju. You all must know about this. So isme hame itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Is MOU mein kya hai, kyun hai, kaun kya karega, that is not required for the exam. Just remember, there is an MOU that has been signed between NSDC and Byju's for imparting skill training to the teachers and trainers under Skill India mission. Okay, and that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.